Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
The truth is proudly brought to you by the IBFP, aka the Fanboy Killer. Keith Thurman destroys Dervonta Stank Davis. And look, let's just break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And we get the first question that comes from the Kool-Aid Man. And he states, what do you think about Tank Davis versus Keith Thurman? I think the narrative of Tank beating Thurman is the dumbest thing I've ever heard. And I'd have to agree 100,000%. I mean, fanboys really do say the dumbest things. You recently seen Leonard Hot Dog Nose Ellaby speak on this publicly via Twitter, and he states Tank Davis is not a 147-pound fighter. Keith Thurman can fight, and he's a guy I got a lot of respect for, but that's a fight I'd make in 2 seconds. Tank would knock him out right now. Trust me, if he's serious, which I highly doubt, that's an easy phone call. It's funny, you see how Leonard Hot Dog Nose Ellaby tries to make Keith Thurman look like he's some kind of coward or an easy fight, saying if he's serious, which I doubt, like he has some reason to be scared of Dervonta Stank Davis. It doesn't make any sense. These guys are literally trying to pump up their fighters off of nonsense. I mean, even Keith Thurman stated that he was approached by all of this, and Leonard Hot Dog Nose Ellaby is acting surprised, like he knew nothing about this. Let's be honest about who Dervonta Tank Davis is. Dervonta Tank Davis is one of the most protected fighters in boxing. They never let Tank Davis fight any risky fight, no matter how big or small the risk is. He's never fought any of the fighters that have been calling him out, that's been trying to fight him. Loma, Farmer, Ryan, Taylor, Teofimo, Haney, and the list goes on and on. Name one of the guys that's been calling him out that he's actually fought. None of them. None of them. He's fought none of these guys. He's literally cherry-picked again and again and again. The guy is being protected. He's the most protected fighter in boxing. And that's not to say that Tank doesn't have potential. That's not to say that he doesn't have upside. He does have speed. He does have a little skill. He does have a little power. But here's the problem. All of that is being misrepresented because anybody looks like a killer fighting an Uber driver. Let's be honest and unbiased. I mean, come on. Look at Dervonta Stank Davis and Leonard Hot Dog Nose Ellaby. Leonard Ellaby states that Tank Davis will fight anybody. Then the next minute turns around and says, oh, he won't fight Josh Taylor, though. This guy is being protected. They will not put him in the fire with any legitimate fighter. I mean, this is the same Leonard Ellaby who makes excuses for him saying, well, you know, no one knows who Josh Taylor is. But at the same time, no one knew who Mario Barrios was. But you fought him. It doesn't make sense. These guys are protecting Tank Davis. They don't want him to have a real fight. And all of this Keith Thurman talk is literally just smoke and mirrors. I mean, Keith Thurman is not Leo Santa Cruz with no power and no defense. Keith Thurman is not Mario Barrios, a guy who was a fake champion. Keith Thurman was a real champion. I mean, let's be honest. Keith Thurman has skills, power, speed, and size, plus experience against top-level fighters in a higher weight class, and Tank Davis has never been tested. Anyone can look like a killer against cherry picks. If you got Tank Davis beating Keith Thurman at this point, you're a moron, idiot, and dummy, and you officially believe hype over facts. But let's keep it going. The next one comes from my brother Black and Brown Boxing, and he states, what's Caleb Plant's next move after ducking Canelo Alvarez? Now, when you see Caleb Plant's next move, he only has two options. One, he either stops smoking crack and accepts the Canelo Alvarez offer and fights him next right away. That's option number one. Option number two is he faces another light touch, a guy like Anthony Durrell, who's calling him out, because he's not facing David Benavidez. He's not taking on any challenges or risk. He's going to hold that belt hostage for as long as he can. But let's keep it going. The next question comes from your mom, and he states, are we ever going to get a face reveal? And you know, this same guy comes on here, seems like every Q&A, and say, hey, when are we going to get a face reveal? When are we going to get a face reveal? If you're looking for a man's face on this channel, this is not for you. You need to go to a channel where you can freely spread your cheeks, because that's not here. Because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.